Hey guys, today's for the install bay. We got a fun one for you. We're doing a Toyota Tundra. It's got a factory JBL system. He wants it pulled out. He's over it, and he wants to put all this stuff in it. Let's get to it. We're going to use Pioneer GMD 9605 5-channel amplifier. We're going to put channels 1 and 2 to the 3.5 in the tweeter, just like the factory. And we're going to put channels 3 and 4 to the 6x9 that's going in the door. Channel 5 is going to go to our subwoofer behind the seat. Some of you might be wondering what he's doing to these speaker bezels. So on the back side of this is plastic, in the truck it's metal. So what we do is we buy this foam, put foam on the back of it so that when we put it on, it's got a nice gasket between the metal and the plastic. The nice thing about Rockford speakers is they already have foam on the back side of them. If it didn't, we would also put foam on the front side of them so that you get a nice bond, right?
Yes.
So we have our mount made. Let's get to the wiring. Now in this case of this amplifier, this has an A-B switch, meaning you have channel A, you have channel B. When you flip the A-B switch to A or A plus B, it'll put the whatever's in channel A into A and B. And in this case, since this is only going to run the front speakers, we don't need to run that third RCA that's the rear, because there'll be no rear going to this. So sometimes when you watch these videos, you might be wondering, hey, why aren't they using this or why didn't they use that? And the reality of it is we're just the installers. Though we get brought in often to console when the initial purchase is being done, sometimes the things that we would like to use don't always get included in the sale, because at the end of the day, it always comes down to what?
The budget.
That's right. So if you're ever wondering why for some reason we didn't use those things, that's pretty much why. We want to use everything. We're crazy, you know, everything. But sometimes we just don't get that opportunity. So back to the install. So we have our Pioneer 8200, and we have all the harnesses that we're pretty sure we're going to need to do the install on this car. Now, the only downside to doing one of these is that trying to put all these pieces together can sometimes be a pain in the butt, because there's not one, even though Best Kits makes a great website that shows this, it doesn't always show this until you buy this, open it up, and then it tells you you need this. And then once you get the radio out of the dash and you find out, oh, I need one of these. So, yeah, they got to work on that. But in the meantime, what we want to do first is we want to mock this thing up, basically do a, not an install, but a partial install, so that we can test to make sure that all these things are going to work in conjunction. And then we'll pull it back out and we'll clean up the wiring harness and make it look all sexy. So the nice thing about this RP42 TY11 is that it'll work on pretty much every Toyota ever made that has an amplifier in it. The harness itself comes with every wiring harness that Toyota has for a radio replacement, which is good and bad. Good for this install, bad because we got to pull out the harnesses we're not going to use just because I can't stand having extra harnesses in the car. So the first thing you want to do anytime you do one of these smart harnesses with steering wheel controls from PAC is set the dip switches for the steering wheel controls. So while getting all the tape off of this and looking at all the harnesses to see what we got going on here, I noticed this little white tag here, and it says supply 6 volts. This is the feed for the factory camera. Now what this is telling me, obviously, is that this isn't a 12 volt feed, so we're going to need a step down from 12 to 6 volts. For that, we use this guy right here. We get these off Amazon. It's a 12 volt to 6 volt converter. I'll put a link to it in the show notes so that you guys know what you're going to need if you're going to do one of these installs. So we finished up our harness, everything is taped up, everything's all secured. We'll be right back. So for this, we're gonna put some 3.5s in the dash, these little Rockford guys here. So what we wanna do is put some base blockers on them, cause the amplifier is not gonna cross them over high enough to keep some of the deep bass out of them. We wanna make sure we get maximum play potential out of them. If you want to learn more about capacitors, we have a video on that. We'll put a link to it in the show notes, of course. Now this thing has these silly little dip switches on it that we set earlier for the steering wheel controls. We like to put some tape over it, only because there's a lot of stuff in the dash, and if you hit one, your steering wheel controls don't work anymore. It kind of sucks. So we have the radio installed, we have the power wire hooked up so we can turn it on, turn on the amplifier. We don't have the speaker wires hooked up yet, and the reason why we don't have them hooked up yet is because we're gonna do a distortion detector with the SMD DD1 so we can set up all our gains. So we can maximize, we'll do the radio, we'll do the amplifier, we'll get it all set. Alright, so for the most part, all the stuff that we're going to do before we get to the auto EQ section is done. We just want to make sure that everything plays like music, and then we're going to go ahead and set up for auto EQ, because this is an 8200 and it has it. All right, so we're all done. We're gonna go ahead and actually listen to it now and do any final adjustments we need to do.
Waited till I saw my hand, my heart, mine.
Okay, what do you think?
Awesome.
Awesome it is. All right, guys. As usual, that brings this one to a close. Thanks very much for watching. We really enjoy that you guys enjoy these, or something like that. Say something to the fine fellows.
So thank you for watching. You guys can find us on Facebook, YouTube, and Instagram.
And we do these things 5 days a week now. It's incredible. Apparently, I never want to sleep. You know? All right. Well, as usual, if you guys have any questions about these, please feel free to leave them in the comments and we will get back to you.
Subscribe.
Yeah, good call. You guys have a great night and we will see you later next time. Bye. Hey,